Hello, my dear students. Welcome again in my YouTube channel. So, in this video lecture, we are going to discuss about a very interesting topic, that is placenta. So, what is placenta? We are going to discuss here. So, placenta, what happens after implantation, students? When zygote is formed, it will get converted into embryo, and this embryo will implant in the uterus, and this process is called as implantation. Okay, students. And next thing is that this is special tissue which is developed between the embryo and uterine wall. This is the placenta, and what happens in placenta? It is a special tissue. You can write. This is a tissue which develops between embryo and uterine wall. Embryo and uterine wall. And this is a disc-shaped temporary connection. As you can see in this picture, this is the placenta area. This color. So this is a disc-like structure which is temporary connection between mother and developing embryo, and this developing embryo is also known as fetus, students. Okay, and when the embryo takes the characteristic human form, when this embryo takes the characteristic human form, it is called fetus till birth. And placenta consists of fetal as well as maternal tissues, and after implantation, chorionic villi of blastocyst, it will grow into endometrium. And you can see here, this is the uterus and this is the umbilical cord which will connect. Okay, and the endometrial tissue undergoes the changes, and this is known as maternal placenta. Okay, this is called maternal placenta. The endometrial tissue, this undergoes changes, and placenta consists of fetal part, the chorionic, and the maternal part is decidua bacillis. You have to remember this point, students, that placenta, it consists of two parts, fetal part, that is chorion. Chorion, and this is ION, and second is decidua bacillis. Decidua bacillis, and this placenta is, what is the role of placenta? It will connect, and with this placenta there will be exchange of the fetus. Fetus in the mother body, fetus exchanges of respiratory gases, nutrients, this will take place, students. And placenta will supply the fetus everything which it needs for development. And CO2 and waste will be removed from fetus to maternal blood, and nutrients from maternal blood to the fetal blood by diffusion. And next thing is about umbilical cord, students. So what is umbilical cord we are going to discuss? So it is a long and thick cord. You can see here, it is a long, and this is wide and thick cord that runs between fetus and placenta. Jo hamara developing fetus, this one is developing fetus and this is placenta. So this cord will connect developing fetus and placenta, and placenta is attached to the uterus. You have to learn this point. This placenta is attached to the uterus and this is developing fetus. Okay, so in this picture, three types of placenta you can see. This is normal placenta, this is low-lying placenta, and this is placenta previa. These are the different conditions which is responsible for the birth of the baby. So this is all about the basics of human placenta, students. And thank you, my dear students, for your continuous love and support. I hope we will meet soon, students. Take care, all of you. Bye bye.